There's nobody. There's nobody like Jehovah. He raised the dead. Healed blind eyes. Opened up doors that were shut in your face. When a doctor walked out on you and said, "You can't do you no good." There's no one like Jehovah. I know what I'm talking about. When your friends walk out on you and wave their hands, but there's no one like Jehovah. He's an awesome God, Tate, that we serve. Facebook, he's an awesome God. Have you tried my Jesus? Saints say he's all right. Have you tried him today? Have you tried him yesterday? And all this week? When did they try him today? I better move on. Amen. Next, we have an invitation, Elder Milton Allen, scripture reading, Deacon Michael Nelson, greeting, Sister Tara Kitwell. An observation for that order. Amen.
Oh Lord Jesus, Lord, we are standing before you this morning. Lord, what a humble heart and a hung down here. Lord, look on us right now, Lord. Look on us in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we need you. I never seen you. Yeah, Lord, we just want to thank you for looking out for us, oh God. Lord, so much trouble in the land. Yeah. People got, hallelujah, trouble all in their heart. Lord. Yeah, Lord. Oh God, we're calling on this, Lord. Lord, touch us in the mighty way, Lord. Those are looking at us or listening to us. Oh God, oh God, oh God. We're just calling on you this morning, Lord.
Yes,
Lord. Lord, people are taking their own lives, Lord. Yes, Lord. Lord, but we know that you know all things. And you're still sitting on the throne. So Lord, touch us in a mighty way, Lord. Lord, give us that. I've never seen that piece of man, Lord. Give us that piece of man. Lord, it's so much safety to love you. Lord, we know that you can heal and deliver, Lord. Lord, we're calling on you. Lord, so many people in the hospital, Lord. Oh, God, they don't know if they're going to make it, but Lord, you know. In the nursing home. Lord, touch us right now, Lord. Lord, give us another seat. Give us a word, Lord. A word of healing and delivering, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, touch the pastor, oh God. Touch him, oh God. Touch him in a mighty way. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, touch the first lady. And all the first ladies. Oh God, oh God, oh God. We're just calling on you this morning, Lord. Lord, we're standing before you. We're standing before your throne, Lord. Oh God, oh God, oh God. Touch us, oh Lord. Touch the service, oh God. Touch it in a mighty way, Lord. Lift those up that need lifting up. Heal and deliver in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray. Thank God. Amen.
Continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let the mouth of you be The angel of the Lord encampeth around about them that fear him and deliver them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusts in him.
Be a God. but we need to set an atmosphere. Glory to God. Oh, I know why I'm here. I'm here to bring deep greetings. Hallelujah. Good morning, Jesus. Hallelujah. You are welcome in this place. And we ask that you have your way today. Glory be to God. There is a word in the house. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody in here needs something before we leave this building. But I believe, God, hallelujah, that what you need is right in here. Hallelujah. What you need, you can find it in the house of the Lord. What you need, hallelujah, is next to you in your neighbor. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm fired up because y'all know my husband will tell you I have church before I get to church. I run in my house. I pray in my truck. I cry in my church. I lay on the floor in my closet. Hallelujah. I don't need a cheerleader. Glory be to God because he's been through God coming.
Down on my floor.
she shall come forth. The deliverance ministry that's on her life is being birthed in this hour right here.
Against the forces of evil. Please join us for our praise and worship experience each Sunday morning at 11 a.m. via Facebook Live or dial the conference call number at 712-770-5561 using the access code 736706 pound. Sunday morning worship may also be viewed via YouTube following the worship experience. Other opportunities for biblical lessons are available on Wednesday evening at 6:30 p.m. for the Bible Band and for Sunday school on Sunday evening at 6 o'clock p.m. for Sunday school. Please join us using the same conference call number as morning worship. We invite our guests to join us for these lessons and to participate if you desire. Thank you in advance for joining us as we learn and grow together by studying the Word of God. God gives us things to share. He doesn't give us things to hold. Give and it shall be given unto you. Please continue to bless this ministry by giving your tithe, offering, and pledge. You may bring your monetary gift to the finance office by 12 p.m. today. To our live stream viewers and members, you may also bless the ministry by using Givelify, Cash App, or mail your gift to Tate Temple, P.O. Box, 193 Arkadelphia, Arkansas, 71923. We appreciate all contributions that have been given toward our building fund project. May God continue to bless you for your generosity and your encouragement as we continue to move forward during the building process of our new edifice. Amen. Williams Funeral Home ribbon cutting and open house will be held this evening at 5 p.m. at 1517 Cattle Street in Arkadelphia. Mr. Roland Dosey is the owner. That's a great accomplishment. Amen. Amen. Sunday school via conference call will be in session at 6:30 p.m. this evening due to the ribbon cutting will be at 6:30 this evening due to the ribbon cutting and the open house ceremony of Williams Funeral Home. Amen. Baptist Health will provide a COVID-19 vaccination clinic on Thursday, August the 12th at Gozo Middle School from 5 to 7 p.m. for ages 12 and under, and over, I'm sorry. And you all, I can't stress that enough. Please go get your children vaccinated because they are returning to a place and an environment that is dangerous. So please, please, please go get your children vaccinated. Open house for Arkadelphia Public Schools will be held on Thursday, August 12th. The schedule for each school is posted on APSD Facebook page, or you may call the school's office for more information. The 13th annual drive-through back-to-school roundup will convene Friday, August the 13th at Arkadelphia Senior Adult Center, 1305 North 10th Street, for ages pre-K through 12th grade. Students must be present to receive items such as backpacks, school supplies, and gift cards. Please wear a mask. These are your observations for August the 8th, 2021. The inspirational thought for today is, when you face difficult times, know that challenges are not sent to destroy you. They're sent to promote you, increase and strengthen you. Have a blessed Sunday and a wonderful week.
Amen. Let's say amen for the announcer. There's one observation that we need to make, that I want to make, on behalf of Sister Chama Williams. And I don't know if any of you knew it or not, but Chama has been in school for the last 2 or 3 years. And she's been online classes. And today I am proud to announce that she has graduated and received her degree in criminal justice. And you know I'm proud of the girl. Pastor and I are proud of some accomplishment. Amen. And we certainly want to celebrate her on next Sunday and give her special consideration. Amen. Like we did the other graduates. Amen. So whatever the Lord lay on your heart to do, bring your graduation gift Sunday. Amen. For Sister Chama. Whatever the Lord lay on your heart to do for her. We appreciate what God is doing through our young people at here at Tate Temple. Young and old, because she ain't that young no more. But to God be the glory. She had the tenacity to go back to school and get her degree. And I'm proud of her. Her accomplishment. God bless you. You're in the hands of Ella Johnson. God bless you.
And thank you, First Lady. Amen. I'm here to present the speaker of the hour, which is no other than Pastor Williams, which is a friend of mine. Amen. I just want to be, I thought about a few things that I got up here, what I could say about him. There's so much that I could say about this man. Up and down the highway, together. When I first came to Tate Temple, he had an aura about him, prestige, kept himself unspotted from the world.
Say that.
Is I'm all right?
That's right.
Amen. And I just looked at him as a leader. Amen. He's not a man of joking, a man of playing around, stuff like that. That's the kind of pastor that we have here at Tech Temple Facebook. Amen. Amen. When I had my surgery, he was by my bedside. Amen. And they put me to sleep. I woke up. I felt good before they put me to sleep because he was in the house. Amen. His mother called Jesus man's in the house, and so I wasn't weary. If God took my life, I wasn't weary. Amen. But, amen, what a great person. A man that would lend a hand, a helping hand, in a time of sorrow, in a time of need. Churches, I'm telling you the truth about this person. Amen. You know, the bishop can trust him. Amen. The district can trust him. He's not going to cheat you out of your money. Amen. He's not going to lie to you. Amen. You know, he already said he's not going to lie for his children or anyone else. Amen. So, saying we got something to be grateful for. I'm going to go to my seat, but I want to tell the truth this morning. I want to give this person what honors do. Amen. Because he's just not any kind of person. Amen. So I want to let everyone know what he means to me. Amen. And during the COVID-19 and all the things that's going on in our world, we got something special. Amen. We got a person who loves the Lord, who knows him. Amen. Some don't even know him. But I believe in my heart that he knows the Lord. Amen. It ain't no shame in his game. Amen. So the next voice you hear after the praise team will be our very own pastor. Amen. So let's just put our happy ears on and see what he has to tell us from the Lord. Amen. May God bless you.
He comes back. I come to. Savior. He's my bread. Hallelujah. God is. God is. God is. My all is my God is. Hallelujah. Come on, testify to somebody. God is. In Jesus' name I pray. Come on, tell him thank you. Tell God thank you. Tell God thank you. Has he done anything for you? Lord, who walked in this morning? Who put food on your table? Strength in your body. Tell somebody God did it. Come on, let's get it out. Because see, if you outlive me one of these days, you all will be coming around looking on my face. But I won't be able to look back at you. So it's a blessing to look on your faces today. Amen. And give you a smile. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. We are the saints of God. We are the saints of God. Amen. Praise God. The hour is going late. Praise God. We just thank God for his blessings. For each of you. Right briefly, and we hope to go into the word. Amen. We look back, you all are, some of you all are plugged in this morning. Plugged in to the power source. Hallelujah. Glory to God. My wife had was saying, stay connected. Stay connected. But in order to stay connected, you first got to be plugged in. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We're going to the book of St. Luke. Briefly, I hope, the 24th chapter. St. Luke, the 24th chapter. Beginning at the 45th verse, 49. Then opened he their understanding, that they might understand the scriptures. And said unto them, thus it is written. And thus it behooves Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day for the seventh, and that repentance and remission of sin should be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. 48 said, and you are witnesses of these things. 49, and behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. Amen. We're going to use for a thought today. Plug it in. Plug it in. Plug it in. Plug it in. Hallelujah. The organ that Deacon Wright is on, it can be plugged in. The power source is already there. The power is already in it. But until he flipped the switch. Hallelujah. Glory to God. See, some of us need to flip the switch. Amen. Because what? It's no noise. It's nothing going to come out of the sound of that organ until he what? Flip the switch. I don't care how much power is running to it. And then in the organ case, he have to hold it, I think, and let it warm up a little bit. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Some of us need to flip the switch and hold it until we get some power, get warmed up. Because we're too cold in church. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. I said we're too cold in church. We testify that we got the power, we saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, but we're too cold. What's wrong? Amen. Praise God. And the way you can turn the switch on is give him some praise. Why are you sitting down on your Holy Ghost? Plug it in. That's the way you get to the power. It's to plug it in. Jesus gives his followers a giant task to do here, which is to reach every nation. To reach every nation. In order to reach every nation, amen, they were going to have to be plugged into the power source. Praise God. Every nation with the saving gospel. But first, he said to wait until they receive the power. Wait until they receive the power. Amen. Praise God. You can't do it without the power. You cannot even witness for God without the power. To accomplish the task, you need the power to accomplish the task. You need the Holy Ghost to do what God has assigned you to do. Don't start without it. Don't start without it. Just because you got a blessing on the altar and you think you're ready and you don't have the power yet, come on, you just felt good, the music sounded good. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. You need the power.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. See, sometimes we just get a little tingling. Mm-hmm. Feeling. I remember hooking up a hot wire one time at home when I was a child, just a teenager. Amen. And I kept fooling with the powers with the wire, but I hadn't cut the switch off. I thought I had. I cut the wrong switch off. But thanks be to God, when I was tying the wires together, putting tape on them, I could have been electrocuted. But I felt a little tingling. God let me feel a little tingling in my fingers. Whoa, something ain't right. So I went back and said, I knew I cut it off. I felt that tingling again. I said, I better go check. And I went back to the switch, and the switch was on. That's why I love the Lord today, because look, he took care of me. I could have been gone when I was a teenager. But he knew he had a gospel for me to preach. So he kept me here. Amen. See, sometimes we get a little like we just get a little tingling. Amen. But you need the full voltage today. The full power of God. Thank you, Jesus. Many folks nowadays will teach you that the Holy Ghost, which is the power, is not needed. I've heard them say it. You don't need it today. That was back then for Paul and Peter and them. You don't need it today. But if they needed it, What's so special about you? You didn't come here holy. You didn't come here filled with the Holy Ghost. You didn't come here without sin. You came in the world with sin just like they did. Therefore, you need the power. It's just an added blessing. It's just an added blessing. Or that it's only for those folks back in the Bible days. Hallelujah. I guess they think that their own human power is all they need. If we could have lived this life on our own power, then Christ could have just stayed in heaven. Didn't have to go to the cross, didn't have to die for us. If we could have done it within our own power. But we needed the power. Hallelujah. Glory to God. They, so to speak, accept the Lord as their Savior and then get started with their mission without waiting for the promise of the Father.
Oh my God.
And when you get started without the power, amen, the devil going to send you back home. He's going to send you home.
That's right.
Praise God, angry, upset, because you went out without the power. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You need power. But I don't read Luke 4:21-49 as an option, but a command.
Amen. Amen.
He said, and behold, I send the promise of my Father unto you. I send it, the promise of my Father unto you. But tarry,
yes, sir,
ye in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. That's what they taught us as children, as teenagers. We had to come to the altar and tarry.
Yeah.
This was our Jerusalem. We had to tarry. We had to go on our knees and pray and stay here Get up, clap our hands, cry out to God, save me, Jesus, save me, Jesus. You all remember, save me, Jesus. We had to tarry for the Holy Ghost. And if you got a good blessing that night, they tell you, no, no, come on back tomorrow night. And get back on the altar again and tarry some more. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I can remember just like it was yesterday. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. See, some of the meals plants that we work in have 161,000 volts. Feeding the transformer yard where it is transformed down to around 13,800 volts. I can remember where I worked, Reynolds Aluminum. We had a transformer yard. And them big wires came in from three different directions into that transformer yard. In case they had a storm somewhere, they had three lines coming into that transformer yard. If they knocked down one line, they kept feeding them. So they had to keep the power going in order to keep that aluminum from freezing. They had to keep the pots hot.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Well.
And then from 13,000 down to 2,300 volts. From there, it distributed to very low centers and then transformed down to 480 volts or 220 volts or 110 volts. That same power that came from the transformer yard, you could run the water cooler on it because you had transformed down to 110 volts. Hallelujah. You have to transform it down to smaller voltage. Then we can make use of the power for different things that call for different voltage. Before we come to the Lord, our pride has us so lifted up. We are no use to him.
Well,
we need to be transformed down. The world tell us in that word tell us in Matthew 23 and 12, and whosoever shall exalt himself shall be abased. And he that shall humble himself shall be exalted. Some of us need to be transformed down. We are too high. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God, we're no use to God and anybody else because we're too high. See, the water cooler couldn't use, praise God, hallelujah, 161,000 volts. It would have just burned it up. But it had to be transformed down. So it could be used for the water cooler. If you get my point. And again in James 4 and 10, he said, humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up. See, best that you humble yourself and let God lift you up than for God to put his hands on you and press you down. Praise God. I want to stay humble so God can use me. Thank you, Jesus. So God can use me. Praise God. And I want to stay humble so even, amen, that I can be a help to you to take temper by humbling myself.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory to God.
Yes, Lord.
We need to be transformed.
Yes, Lord.
It says, and be not conformed, behaving, we need to be behave acceptable. Follow standards, be of made similar, the word conform, to this world, but we should be transformed. See, we don't want to be acceptable to the world.
That's it.
We don't want to follow the standards of the world.
Amen.
We don't want to be similar like the world.
Amen.
I don't ever want somebody to say, oh, Leroy is just like the world. Oh, Leroy, just like so-and-so. Somebody just cutting up all the time. No. Mm-mm.
Oh God, oh God.
I don't want that labor.
Amen.
Saying I'm following the standards of the world. But we transformed by the renewing of your mind. That you may prove what is that's good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Romans 12 and 2. We want to be acceptable to God and do the perfect will of God.
Yeah,
we need to be a vessel or a device that is plugged into his power.
Yeah.
Are you plugged in?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Look at your neighbor and say, are you plugged in?
Are you plugged in?
Are you just close to the socket? See, just being close to the socket ain't gonna get you the power. You gotta be plugged in.
Yeah.
You ever try to use an appliance and you turn the switch on? What's wrong? Is something wrong with it? And you trace it back, you look back, you look at the plug at the socket, and it's not plugged in. But as soon as you plug it in, the power is there. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We need to be a vice that is plugged into his power, and his power will transform us into something usable.
All right.
Something usable. You want to be used by God?
Yeah.
See, God can't use you if you're not plugged in.
That's it.
If you're not connected to the source.
That's it.
If you're not connected to him.
That's it.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. He told no ego witness until you be endued with the power from on high. Then you can become a witness. I don't even want you out there using my name. Telling folks what I can do and what we can do. Wait until you get the power.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Unless we are plugged into the source, we are not no use in the kingdom of God.
That's it.
Unless you plugged in.
That's it.
That organ is no good to us if it's not plugged in.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care how he runs the keys, the keyboard, it's no good to us. We want some sound. We want to hear the music.
Yes, sir.
So it got to be plugged in.
Yeah.
We're no use to God unless we plugged in.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Unless we are plugged into the source, we are no use in the kingdom of God. Romans 8 and 9 say, without the Spirit of Christ, we are none of his. If you don't have Christ, I don't care how you say I belong to the Lord. I know the Lord. He's mine. He's my friend. If you don't have the Spirit of Christ,
yes,
you are none of his.
None of
his. Hey. He don't even claim you.
That's right.
Thank you, Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. And when you got the Spirit of Christ, then you're going to love like Christ.
Yes,
by this shall all men know that ye are my disciples. You have love what? One to another.
Amen.
Amen. You can say it all day. But if you don't love like Christ,
right.
You're none of his.
Right.
God has wanted us to reconnect with him ever since the fall in the garden.
Yeah.
Yeah. Where man was disconnected from God. He was separated from God.
Yeah.
Reconcile means to reconnect.
Yeah.
Reconnect.
Yeah.
If you have disconnected yourself, you can reconnect.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Just because your place, God, your appliance is unconnected, you don't take it outside, throw it in the trash.
Mm-hmm.
Just because it's disconnected.
Uh-huh.
And then you plug it back in.
Yeah.
And run a test and see is it working.
That's right.
You don't just throw it away because you forgot to plug it in and it's not working. You need to beat this cake up this morning and the beater's not working because you didn't plug it in. You don't take it, throw it in the trash. Hallelujah. God just don't throw us away when we disconnect. We have an advocate. He wants us to come back. He wants us to reconnect to him. Amen. Praise God. But if you don't reconnect in time, you're lost. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 5:18 said, and all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And has given to us the ministry of reconciliation.
Yeah.
Amen. We have the ministry. We have the power to go out, to go to different one. Amen. Those that have been disconnected and talk to them and encourage them and pray for them and try to get them reconnected.
Yeah.
That's our ministry.
Yeah.
He didn't save you. Just sit down.
That's it.
Hallelujah.
Ah, mama.
So I got mine now. I'm connected. I don't care about anybody else. That's not the way it works. God wants us because he has given us that ministry. He's not coming back in person right now and walk the streets of Arkadelphia, of Jerusalem, amen, preaching and teaching and trying to get people to be saved. He's given us that ministry. He's given us the power to minister to others, to bring them to him. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. You see, he wants us back, and he has given us the ministry to help others get reconnected to him. He wants us back so that bad that he had transformed himself down to our level. He came all the way down from glory, hallelujah, to our level. Amen. Praise God. Came to us in the form of a man. In the form of a man to reconnect us. Jesus Christ, the only mediator, bridged the gap. He's the only one. Therefore, you can't do it on your own. You got to have Jesus to help bridge the gap. How could he do that? Because he was both 100% man and he was 100% God. See, Jesus is the adapter or the connector, so to speak. I remember when I went to Germany in the military and I bought a TV that was made in America. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. The 110 volt is what it needed to run the TV. Mm-hmm. But the Germany, the department that was set up, it was on like 220. So I had to go get an adapter. So I can plug the TV into the adapter because it transformed the power down from the plug-in to 110. Because if I had plugged my TV in over there where they use 110, it would have just burned it up. Thank you, Jesus. So Jesus is the adapter or the connector, so to speak. But still, some folks don't want to get connected.
Yes, sir.
That's right.
They don't want to get connected.
That's right,
they want to come to church. They want to sing in choir. They want to be on board. They want positions in the church, but they don't want to get connected. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. God wants you connected to the power of souls. Thank you, Jesus. He wants you filled with the Holy Ghost. Someday, some say it's not necessary, or they think they are connected without receiving the Holy Ghost. There's a lot of folks in church testifying today. Amen. Are singing today, think that everything is all right. And they're not connected to the power of soul. Just because I'm here this morning, everything is all right. Just because I give my tithes and offering, everything is all right. But you're not connected. You don't have the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. They think they're connected without receiving the Holy Ghost. But you see, anytime something gets connected, they are filled with the power of the sword from which they are connected to.
That's right.
Yeah. Hallelujah. That organ is filled with the power. Yeah. It's already connected. Yeah. All it needs is the switch turn on. Yeah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's already connected. It's already got the power running to it. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That was the whole purpose of Jesus coming to the earth. He could have stayed in heaven. Could have left us disconnected. Could have left us lost. But he said, Father, prepare me a body. And I'll go down. I'll go down and reconnect me. I'll reconcile it back to you. I'll reconnect it. Amen, with a good bulb in it. Nothing wrong with it. But until you plug it in to the power source, you won't be in the dark until you plug it in. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. because you're not plugged in. You wave your hand, you shout, you dance, but you're not plugged in. Hallelujah. If I plug a lamp into the source, and now the power that was available from the outlet is now in the lamp. You get plugged into Christ, the power. Hallelujah. That was in Christ, now is in you. It's in you. That same power, that same Holy Ghost. You get plugged into Christ, that power is in you. Amen. You can walk upright. You can talk right. You can live right. You can shout right. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let me close. When we repent, get buried in the name of Jesus, and then filled with the Holy Ghost, we have been reconnected. Let me say that again. When we repent, get buried in the name of Jesus, and then filled with the Holy Ghost, we have been reconnected. Ask your neighbor this morning, have you been reconnected? But once we have been reconnected, we have to make use of the power we have been connected to. You got to make use of the power. You got to tell somebody else about Jesus Christ and Him crucified. You got to tell somebody. You got to make use of the power. You got to lay hands on the sick. Glory to God. Make use of the power. It's no good to have the power of the Holy Ghost if you make no use of it. Make no use of it. I don't mind going to church. I don't mind being in Bible study. I don't mind being in Sunday school. I don't mind conducting praise service. But I just can't tell nobody. I cannot be a witness to anybody. I'm not bold enough to tell them about their sin. God wants you to connect to Him and tell others, because you already have the power to do His will. Thank you, Jesus. It's no good to have the power if you're just going to sit there and do nothing. Hallelujah. What use of a brand new car sitting in my garage? I can't drive. Don't have a license. Won't let nobody else drive it. It's just sitting there. What use is it? Glory to God. You got the power. And just sitting there. Just sitting doing nothing. Will you do this? No. Will you do this? No. Will you serve here? No. Just sitting there doing nothing. We have been given the ministry of reconciliation. That means get busy. Win souls. And tell them of Jesus. Teach them how to get reconnected. That's our responsibility. That's our responsibility, is to tell others how to get connected to God. Say yes. If a lamp is plugged in and you're not using it, you don't put the power to work, it's useless. I say it's useless. It's useless. Jesus gave us the power to fulfill a mandate, a command, a task. He gave us the Holy Ghost for a purpose. For a purpose. For a purpose. Hallelujah. Go out and witness after you have received it. That's your purpose in life, is to tell others about Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, that He saved. He's sanctified. He's filled with the Holy Ghost. That's our purpose. It's to witness, to testify, to teach, preach, and reach. Hallelujah. Reach somebody else. Sometimes you have to reach down. How do I get plugged into his power? Well, notice that plug has two prongs. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We need to raise out our two prongs up to the source and worship God. Thank you, Jesus. We need to worship him. I have one prong of spirit and another of truth. We need to raise them. The spirit and truth. Glory to God. In spirit and in truth. After you have been obedient to the word, you humble yourself. You repent. Seek him. Ask him. Then lift up your hands and praise him. He will connect you to his power. He will fill you with the Holy Ghost. All you have to do is just raise your hand. Praise him. Ask him for it. Tell him to fill you with the Holy Ghost. He'll connect you to the power of God. How do I put it to use? Plug it back in and turn it on. Turn it on. Turn it on. Say yeah. Hallelujah. Turn it on. Turn on the power. You got the source. You plugged in. Turn it on. Hallelujah. Let your light shine before all you. Witness and testify as food on the job at Walmart. Pray with people. No matter where you're at, minister them. Invite them. Hallelujah. When the last time you turn on the power and invited somebody to the house of the Lord, teach them at home Bible study, or even a 30-minute lesson doing lunch. Thank you, Jesus. I've oftentimes heard, I believe, Missionary Hillard and lunch hour. Deacon Hillard and lunch hour. Sitting around the table telling somebody about Jesus Christ. Work for the kingdom. Don't let the power go on you. Win souls. Win souls. We need a little commotion. See, when you get connected to electricity, it's gonna be a little commotion going on. You ain't gonna just sit still. If your hand touches it, it's gonna, it's hot. Thank you, Jesus. It's gonna be a little, if something goes by you, you may knock it over. Why? Because you just got connected to the power source. So it's gonna be a little commotion going on. Thank you, see, we need a little commotion around here to wake it up. Wake up, people. Hallelujah. When people got saved, when they got filled with the Holy Ghost, when they were rolling on the floor, it got everybody's attention. We standing up in the pew, looking down on the floor, seeing what's going on. Say yes. When the last time we had that kind of commotion going on in the church, that somebody stood up in the pew, looking, seeing what's going on. Thank you, Jesus. God, I want to get the Holy Ghost. I want to get Holy Ghost fried. Holy Ghost fried. See, that prison will fry you. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. So I want to get Holy Ghost fried. I want it to burn me. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. I want to be toasted in his power. When someone comes in contact with the power of God in church, it seems that it awakened everyone in the building. Everyone in the building. Praise God. Don't let it be somebody, amen, that's brand new. That they come up in the church and they came and they got filled with the Holy Ghost. They're being filled with the Holy Ghost. They roll it on the floor. It gets everybody's attention. Thank you, Jesus. So we need some more of that. So people put up the cell phones. They put away their tablets. Because what? Something's going on down here. Somebody get filled with the Holy Ghost. It's awakening everybody. Let's have Book of Acts, Holy Ghost, awakening revival. We need a revival. We need soul saving. We need to be people being connected to the power of God. We need the Holy Ghost to fall again. Yes! Fall again! Oh, too many people coming to church, leaving without the power. And some of us look like we've been around church so long. We had the power. We were plugged in. But we let the devil unplug us. We're still coming. We're still doing this and that. But we're still unplugged. Plug yourself back in. Plug it in. Plug it in. Broken. power, amen, to be them, coming to the house. He wasn't getting his full load, coming to the house. So he had to dig it up and replace it, tie it back in together. And when he did that, my lights were bright, because they were getting the full load. If you're not getting the full load, if your spirit of life is dim, you're not getting the full load. Oh, check yourself. Check your connection. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
God. Praise God. And for the seat, Sister Todd here this morning. God bless you. I could ask Brother Justin to get off that arm and turn it off. I go over there and put up keys, act like I'm playing, pretend I'm playing. But y'all would know what I'm playing or not if you didn't know I could play. Because you couldn't hear that. We got to go pretend it. To be connected. Is there one today?
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. It's good. All you have to do is just plug in to the power source. Thank you, Jesus. And once you plug in, it's the first thing that says stay connected. Thank you, Jesus. Stay connected. Plug in. They trip over the wire every now and then. But plug back in. Ask God to forgive me. Repent. See, when you repent, you plug it back in. See, think about God, he don't force his power on you. You have to plug into the power. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you for the offerings today. We pray you on Joe's blessing of each and every one that has given. Bless those that you desire to give but didn't have. We pray that you will make a way that they have to hear the next word and call. Many blessings we ask in our Son Jesus' name. Amen. This time, Mr. Wright is coming back. This time, say amen as you come.
And Tate Temple Church of God in Christ. Congratulations to you, First Lady Dolores, and the entire Tate Temple family on the start of building God's new temple. What a grand celebration for a temple that has endured over 100 years there in Arkadelphia, carrying out the Great Commission to spread the good news. My wife, Doris, and I would like to donate to your building fund the sum of $300. Amen. We look forward to seeing you all on our next trip to Arkadelphia, loving God, loving others. Larry and Doris Williams out of Springfield, Virginia. Today I want to give you a brief update on the handkerchiefs or the lap scarf sales, which was a project for the build for our building fund. For 2020, the year 2020, there was $140 submitted. Cash App on July 20th of 21, $57. And for the month of August, $153, which brings a total sale of $350 for the building fund project. And I want to just thank everyone that supported that small project. Every little bit helps. Amen. Thank you so much for your support of the lap scarf sale. God bless.
One night Ames meeting, one night Ames meeting, September the 10th, which will be on a Friday night. If you notice, we did not have a district Ames for each auxiliary, so we're going to have a one night Ames service on September the 10th, and all the Ames department of the district will be functioning. They'll be doing a presentation for about 10 minutes or 15 minutes. And we ask you to prepare yourself, mark it on your calendar, September the 10th on Friday night, the Ames, one night Ames service. And we'll let you know later what we'll be asking you to support with. Amen, during that night to bless our Ames presidents for the year. They've been out of money also for the state. And so we want to do something for them. Because of the pandemic, we just going to have the one night. And there will be so many people to be allowed in the building. So mark it on your calendar, September the 10th. That's on Friday night.
Thank you, Jesus.
For District AIM one night service. Thank you. At this time, if there's nothing else, we're going to give it to Missionary Hillock to come and give us our benediction. Hope to see you this afternoon, some of you, at the Williams Funeral Home.
Amen.
You know, Roland has been nice to us.
Yes, yes.
Amen. Those, amen. One of those tents that you were sitting under doing the groundbreaking, that was Williams and Mitchell Funeral Homes. They just donated the use of their tents. Their workers put them up for us and took them down. And we didn't have to pay one dime. So we just thank God for the funeral home here in Arkansas. God bless you.
Pastor, can I just say a word, please?
Yes.
Well, first of all, I thank God for being here. It's so good to see all you beautiful faces. And I thank God because you all just don't know. On Monday, my daughter was in a head-on collision. The airbags came out.
Thank you.
And when she sent me these pictures yesterday of that car, where it was just torn apart, blood on the airbags, I just praise and thank God. Y'all see, she could have been done.
Yeah.
Unto God. The scripture that the Lord, the benediction of the scripture that the Lord gave me today is from Jude. And I enjoyed the word, Pastor. Continue to speak the word of God that he give to you to give to feed to your flock, because we are under your care. Hallelujah. And the woman of God, woman of faith, continue to be obedient unto God. The services are not as usual as they're going to be from now on. Yet we know our place in the sanctuary, in the household of God, and under the man of God. Let us be obedient to the will of God. And that's the reason why the Lord dropped this scripture in my spirit. It says, now unto him that is able to keep you from falling. And to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceedingly joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. You are dismissed.
God bless you, saints.